So yes, moving on, let's move to the topic for today, and it is emotional well-being. I was reading an article recently by the World Health Organization, where it says that the COVID-19 pandemic has disrupted or halted in 93% of the countries worldwide, while the demand for mental health is increasing. According to a new survey, the survey of 130 countries provides that the first global data showing the devastating impact of COVID-19 on access to mental health services and underscores the urgent need for influencing increased funding. I'm sorry. Now, the WHO has previously highlighted that the chronic underfunding of mental health prior to the pandemic in the countries were spending less than 2% of their national health budgets on mental health and struggling to meet their population needs. So while they do accept and they are doing a lot of things to promote mental health, it is not enough. And hence we thought that this would be a wonderful topic, or rather a very insightful topic to discuss in today's session. And for that, we have Stuti Das with us. Stuti, thank you so much for taking the time to talk about a topic which is, of course, very close to your heart, and I'm sure to a lot of other people as well. So thank you, Stuti. And here is a little introduction for those of you who have interacted with Stuti. You already know her, but for the rest of you, Stuti is the Vice President of MICE of the Western Region of Corporate Tours, SOTC. She had completed her master's in business administration, specializing in marketing from University of Pune, and also has successfully completed her post-graduation in economics from Gokhale Institute of Politics and Economics in Pune. With almost 25 years of extensive experience in the travel industry, in sales, product development, contracting and purchasing, Stuti has been pivotal in conceptualizing, designing, and executing effective strategies for the corporate tours division at SOTC. She started her career at SOTC in August 2001 and is currently Vice President of MICE at SOTC Travel. Prior to SOTC, she was also working with Thomas Cook for 2.5 years. And as a salesperson in Kuoni Corporate Tours Department for 12 years, she took up the challenge of setting up the MICE Central Procurement Cell and has effortlessly serviced incentives and conferences for the big corporate houses across industries. She has exceptional skills in maintaining personal relationships and a sound reputation of managing people and developing dynamic team members. She successfully managed ad hoc business for a brief period and gave direction and confidence to the team. And as Vice President of MICE Western Region, her key focus is to build a working culture driven by innovations and strategies, and to lead a result-oriented, motivated business teams to achieve sales and profit goals. Her dedication, rich experience, and excellent business knowledge have brought tremendous value to the organization. So it is our pleasure to hear from her. And also, apart from knowing her on a professional level, I thought we'll do a quick round of, the usual fastest finger first with a little bit of a twist, so that we get to know some more things about her on a personal level. So are you all set for this? Are you able to see my screen?
Yes, all set.
Okay, great. Now,
Yeah.
those of you who know her extremely well, please hold your horses. Okay? So here goes. We're going to see where this question goes. All right. So the first question for you, Kati. The country, now this is not for Stuti, this is for everybody else first. And Shravan, you might have to help me with the chat as I'm not able to see it. But what do you think is the country she would love to settle down in? People on
India.
the chat. People on the chat. Come on.
India.
People say India, US,
UK.
UK, Switzerland.
Who is the closest? Stuti.
Hungary.
A few of my colleagues know me well. Given an opportunity, I would love to settle down in the US because both my sisters are there, plus all my cousins are there. I'm the only one from this generation who's here. Plus, I think it would give a better quality life for my son. So, yes, US is the option. If I have a second option, I wouldn't mind going back to Assam one day and settle there.
Lovely, lovely, great, thank you. Okay. Let's move on. Go ahead and put down what do you think are the kind of movies she enjoys?
Action, comedy. action, comedy, emotional. Okay. Cultural. I see more of comedy coming in.
Yeah, I like light entertaining movies like The Three Idiots or The Holiday. I don't know how many of you have watched this movie, Catch Me If You Can, Tom Hanks. Yes. I like to take the messages, you know, which we get from all the any movies. So if you remember Frank saying in this movie, especially in this movie, that there are two mice who fell on the cream. And the first mouse, he surrendered and he died. And the second mouse, he struggled so much that the cream turned into butter and he crawled out. So I think I like to be the second one. So I like these messages. Also, I like the inspiring movies like, The Queen or, you know, the recent one that Gunjan, what is that? What's her name? The fighter pilot, something like that. Or even Cast Away, again, Tom Hanks.
So
those movies which leaves us with so much of hope, which, you know, allows us to fight, struggle through all our, you know, physical, emotional, or any, you know, mental health time. So these are good movies. I think you should go watch if you haven't.
Okay. Sure. Thank you. Okay, the next one. Okay, I'm sure they'll get this one.
Alaska cruise, wow, I wish.
So there's Turkey, there is Switzerland, there's Norway, Europe tour, Assam, Kashmir, Kashmir, Antarctica. I think we are all getting into going round
the globe. Yes, I would love to travel all over as long as my family is with me. When I say my family, my parents, my both my sister's family and my son together. So I think in the year 2017, we had a family reunion in Minneapolis. That's where my sister stays. And that too, after 15 years. So it was a great moment for all of us because they do come down, but all three of us wouldn't meet back home together. So year 2017, all of us were together. That was an excellent time which we had. And we again recreated that moment the next year in Assam. And we would love to do that more often.
Great.
Yes. Anywhere along the family.
Wonderful. Person you admire. Who do you think? Okay. This is a very wide question, right? It could be so many.
I think if so many of them have said, mother, yes, I really admire my mom. She's one strong lady I look up to because what we are today, all my three sisters, is obviously she has the support of my dad. Because I remember as a 10-year-old, she was preparing for her APSC exams for a good 4 or 5 months. And one fine day, my granddad told her, the best job for you would be to raise these three daughters and make them successful. You know, with a smile, without even saying anything to him, she just gave up the idea of writing the exams. Even as a kid, I felt bad at that point of time. And then when I was in my second year of my graduation, we decided with three sisters, because we had grown up now by then. So it's time for her to move out of the house. And actually, that's how MBs, our small family restaurant, was born 30 years back. We celebrated 30 years last year. And I don't think it was easy for her, for a woman of that at that time, you know, in a male-dominated society and that in a place like Assam, to come out of all the obstacles and be a successful entrepreneur. I really look up to her. She's a one strong woman. I really admire her.
Thank you. Thanks for sharing. So, Stuti, you are a foodie, is what I've heard.
Yeah.
Okay.
Who doesn't like to cook?
A foodie who doesn't like to cook. So, who do you think, guys? What do you think? Not who. I mean, what do you think is her favorite cuisine?
Non-veg, but
anything that's non-veg. Okay. All right. Is anybody close to you? Is anyone close to the answer?
Actually, I like, or I mean, I eat everything. Or people make fun of me saying that I eat anything that moves. So whoever says that, I tell them, you guys be careful then. But yes, I do enjoy good food. So whether it is a Thai or a continental, I mean, thanks to the profession, I've got the opportunity to travel across the world. So have, you know, tried everything which is possible in all those exotic locations.
Yeah, wonderful. Wonderful. Okay, last two questions. Sleeping. Yes. Okay, I think everybody's Sunday more or less looks the same.
Yeah, I think everyone's gone wrong here except for Shana's, a few of them who knows me well. I am not a person who's lazy. I'm not a person who likes sleeping. For me, you know, I'm on an activity mode always. You know, that's what energizes me. That's what vibrates me. So a Sunday, yes, it is true that it's definitely exclusively reserved for my son, Siddhant. But we do everything together, be it organizing the house or running errands for the whole week, because we need to do everything managed during the weekends, or, you know, go for a drive to Marine Drive or to the race course and do our 1.5 hours of rounds, you know, walk out there and come back, have good food. Evening again, we go out, explore some good restaurants. But of course, this exploring restaurant was the pre-COVID era. So today we try to do stuff at home because he's learning to do, I mean, he's in the catering classes doing his vocational course. So we try to do things at home. So yes, that's how my typical Sunday looks like.
Okay. And the last one, of course, is, yeah, there's just one question. Your favorite... superhero.
Daddy.
Shaktiman. Wow. Okay, most of them are saying, okay, we have a Wonder Woman. We have Amitabh Bachchan also.
People who are answering Wonder Woman are definitely from the Mice West team, for sure. Yes, Dad is my superhero because I have learned the strong values of life from him. But I like the names Wonder Woman, and that too because one of our very, you know, dear corporates have given me this name. I'll give you that story behind as well. In one of our tours, you know, and just, you know, take care of this timing. At 10:40 in the evening, and that too on a Friday evening, the senior most person, the management, comes and tells us that they need a charter flight to be organized from Queenstown to Christchurch, and that too for a Monday morning. Saturday, Sunday, no one works in New Zealand. So thankfully, stars were in our favor. Our ground handler was very resourceful, and we did manage. Nothing did I do, but I did get the name. And after that, they always search for Wonder Woman, and whenever they search for Wonder Woman, I know there is trouble ahead. So that's why I like Wonder Woman.
Thank you so much. And I guess that's all the time we have for that, though it was a lot of fun. Now we know a little more about you, Stuti. And we're about 117 people, and I'd like to take this opportunity, because we do have Mr. Menon as well with us. I'd like to wish you, sir, a very happy birthday. Today is Mr. Menon's birthday. And
Mr. Menon. Yes.
Thank you, Stuti. Thank you, everyone. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for being a part of it, and we hope that you have a wonderful day. So,
thank you, Monica.
Right. Great. So, Stuti, I hope you're all set. We have a couple of questions lined up for you, and you know, we're really looking forward to what you would have to say about these. So, the very first question, I'm sure it's on everybody's mind, is we're talking about emotional well-being over here.
To our decision-making process, how we handle stress, how we relate to one another and make decisions. You know, being emotionally healthy makes us feel energized and also drives us to think positively and work effectively. It helps us to adapt to the changes in our lives and to cope with adversity. I can give you my example right away what has happened. I mean, I really got stressed. I mean, this is the time where we were looking forward to, and this had to happen. Honestly, my first couple of minutes, my brain was not working at all. But then at the end of the day, I had to come down and say, you know, I need to take charge of this situation. So it is easier for us to say that we should always stay positive, even, you know, we know that all these uncertainties are playing around in our heads with so much of stress and uncertainties around. So least what we could do at this point of time is to be kind, compassionate, and empathetic towards all. Everyone, I would say, is fighting their own battle, big or small. And it is this time that we need to add value and enrich human connection, enrich each other's lives. So research says that if we are, the gratitude is strongly associated with greater happiness. So if we start our day with a grateful heart, it fills our mind with so much of positivity. So for example, I would say, let us thank God for a brand new day. You know, because it gives us so much hopes. It leaves us with so much hopes in front of us. You know, I would appreciate the strong support system that I'm backed up by, because of whom and which I'm being able to work today and maintain a balance between my work front and my, you know, personal front. Now, feel blessed that I'm healthy and someone else might be fighting the virus and would, you know, love to leave our life. So we should also not forget that we should spread love and kindness. You know, helping others would help us feel much better about our own life. So I would say, Monica, that emotional well-being or mental health is not just important only during this pandemic time, but at every stage of our life.
True. Absolutely. Great. You know, you did mention, you know, you gave the examples about support, and a lot of us are working without, you know, house help. And how important would you say support is, and who has been your support to strike that balance at work and home?
Good question. In fact, I feel truly blessed that I have a strong support system, both at my personal as well as my professional level. No, being a single mom, and also when your job demands you to travel so extensively, would not have been possible if I would not have had a strong support from my family. You know, there were times where my parents had to fly all the way from Assam to Mumbai just to take care of my son while I was traveling, so that I could focus on my job and deliver as per all my commitments. I'm also grateful, and I was lucky that my aunt came and stayed with me for almost 5 years during the most crucial time of my life when I required her the most. Today, neither my elderly parents nor my aunt can physically help me, but they're still the biggest support when it comes to keeping my mental health intact. At my professional front, you know, my journey with SOTC has only been possible only because of the support which I have got from the management till date. You know, fingers crossed, you already mentioned that I joined in the year 2001. Yes, 16th of August, I'll be completing 20 years in this organization. And we all know during this last 20 years, there has been a change in management level. But then one thing I would like to stress, which has not changed, is the culture of the organization. You know, the culture to take care of the employees' well-being has still remained the same. So just to give you an example, women play multiple roles in our society, right? And there was a time where the role of a mother required more attention in my life. So I would have to either leave my job, go on sabbatical, if I would not have come forward and spoken with my immediate senior, my boss, and the HR in the year 2006. You know, way back in the year 2006, when the concept, when the word flexi timing was never heard of, at least in the travel industry, I was allowed to walk into the office by noon and leave by four, as I had to attend the therapy sessions along with my son, who has special needs. So, and this continued for more than two and a half years. But trust me, just because I did not put in the required number of hours in the office, never affected my sales numbers that I had to achieve. In fact, on the contrary, those were the 3 years where we used to achieve something which was called a goal target during those years. That means we used to achieve our target by the end of Q3, and we used to take additional target for the next two to three months. And again, I would like to highlight here that this was possible because I had an excellent team. I was always lucky, and I consider myself lucky still to have a strong, energetic, and a result-oriented team. The team today has gradually taken over my extensive traveling schedule too, allowing me to balance my work and my home front. So I'm really thankful to the strong HR system and the management out here, because of whom I'm still enjoying my professional career with SOTC. The message out here is, guys, if you have any issues with you, do not keep it to yourself. Walk, come forward, talk it out. Only if you talk it out, express, share your issues, then only it can be addressed. Then only you will find solutions. Thank you. I hope I'm audible, Monica.
Yes, absolutely, Stuti, you are. And on that note, and you mentioned about coming out there and speaking up and not keeping things to yourself, do you feel that there is a more proactive way to ensure that we don't fall into this trap of anxiety or getting into a depressive state? Is there something that you feel we could proactively do before we even reach that state?
Yeah, I would say emotional health is more a process than a goal. You know, trying to stay positive does not mean that you are in the best of the mood always, right? I mean, it is learning how do we deal with our difficult situation. This last 5, 10 or 15 minutes, I knew what I went through. So how to deal with it calmly would actually mean how you actually control your mind. So if there are the scientific techniques and scientific methods of trying to keep you proactive so that you control your anxiety levels. One is, it's called the five a day program. So what are these 5 a day program? One is connecting. I'm just telling you the five a day program, and I will try to relate this with the stories. Okay. One is connecting. Next is be active. Third would be to be cautious, to take notice of things. Fourth is learning. And the fifth is giving. So how do I try to cope stress? I will start with trying to be active. Like I said, I'm not a person who would want to just sleep and lie down and just be lazing around. No, that's not me. I would like to maintain a rhythm and routine for each day. You know, taking time out for your physical activity. So the moment you wake up in the morning, if you realize, do you have time for yourself? Answer is no, your entire day is mapped out. So don't you think you at least deserve a couple of hours, at least that me time for your own self? So I would like to regularly go for my walks at least for 1-1.5 hours every day in the morning. I remember in the last session, Endeavor did mention that the one thing he would like to, you know, change or like to do is to try to get up early. So it is definitely one good habit which would keep you energetic. And people who have this habit would understand what I'm, or could relate to what I'm trying to say here. I know Manav is one colleague of ours who, you know, has a very good habit of getting up early and going for his walk. And it's walking is not because I want to keep myself physically fit. It's because it also keeps us mentally fit. Whether, you know, when you're going for your morning walks, whether it is looking out at the field and noticing the trees, which is beginning to bud, or the sound of the birds, you know, the chirping of the birds, or the morning sunrise, you know, I try to capture these moments. You know, honestly, try to enjoy these moments. If you start your day with lots of, you know, positive energies, lots of brightness in your life, your entire day is going to go well. I think Monica has shared a picture. I mean, this is one of the pictures which I have captured while I was going for my walks. I mentioned to you guys that I, on Saturday weekends, I try to drive down to Marine Drive and then do my rounds there. But how many, we must have driven in Marine Drive so many times, drive past Marine Drive, but how many of us have noticed there are such beautiful bright flowers, which actually brightens the day. Monica, is it possible for you to show those?
Yes.
See, these are the flowers in Marine Drives and those pavement where we start, people start jogging. It's so beautiful. Also, I mean, there are the pets which roam around early morning. You know, one of those days where I've taken my son out in the open to do his yoga, and there is this pet who's not even ours, comes and he was actually staring at my son doing exercise. And look at that. That's not a fabricated picture or a Photoshop. This is this guy who's coming and doing exercise along with my son. This actually brings a smile in your face. And this is how I brighten my day. And that's what keeps me going. So this is one, you know, like be active is one of the points which I've covered. See, this is another picture which Monica is sharing, where while in Marine Drive, there you have the leader of the, they have also come out for a nice warm sun bath.
It's a very interesting picture.
So these are nice stories which we can create while we are even walking, you know. So this is how I try to keep myself energized early morning so that I have a productive day throughout, you know. That's one of the ways. Also, we say if we eat healthy, if we sleep well, these are the things which boost up our immunity level. And this helps us to reduce stress. You know, when we work out, actually, when we do our exercises, we're to try to keep ourselves fit, it reduces the elevated cortisol levels. Now, what are these cortisol levels? It's the body's main stress hormones. And also when you're you feel happy, when you share, you know, when you feel happy, you smile, you release the endorphins level. That's the happiness hormones. So why can we not just only take care of, why should we only take care of our physical fitness? Along with physical fitness, we also take care of our emotional fitness. So this is how, this is one of the ways how we can proactively try to contract our anxiety or depression. Yeah. Next would be, I would say, yes, I have also addressed saying that staying positive doesn't mean that we are in the best of the moods always. So there are moments where it is possible that you feel low, you know. So instead of getting upset or reacting to such, it has happened to me in the office. There are times where I get upset. And I mean, I have my colleagues also who tells me, boss, just leave it, drop it and take a break. And what do I do then? I try to connect with my folks. But yes, at times, immediately when you're upset, it's not right to connect with your family because the frustrations levels goes there. But then trust me, if someone who knows you well, they also know that you're trying to connect with them so that you feel lightened up. So when you feel upset, when you feel low, I mean, not just always, and otherwise also, you should try to connect with your loved ones, with your friends. You know, it helps to lift up your spirits. It lightens your mood. It reduces your stress levels. So this is the point which I was trying to cover for connectivity. The third was learning. You know, it's unfortunate, but it's true that it takes a global pandemic for all of us to really force us to reflect on our priorities of life and how we spend our time. You know, I have started to value family and friends, you know, where earlier maybe I never thought of calling up my elderly uncles and aunts, because I know for sure, I mean, we have seen what life is. I have lost my immediate neighbor who has become the victim of COVID-19, my family members, seniors, also young ones. So I consciously try to make an effort to connect with my relatives whom I've never tried to connect over the last 2-3 years. They also feel good. Like I said, all my cousins are abroad. If they hear a voice, I mean, if you share happiness, if you make someone happy, at the end of the day, you yourself will feel happy. So try to do these things which you have never done in the past.
Okay. So is there anything new that you learned in terms of skills during this time, which you are not doing previously?
Yeah, I would say, you know, like I said, I am a person who doesn't like this kitchen space at all. So this is the time I have learned how to bake, and that too from my son. The happiness which I have got is immense out here because, like I mentioned, my son has special needs. There was a time where the doctors mentioned when he was 2 years old that he is not a normal child. And for him to come to this, I mean, this, the progress of his really makes me happy. And when he is teaching me how to bake, that happiness cannot be compared. I also remember Vishal mentioning that he tried to replicate the chicken curry, which his mother used to make. So these are the things which makes us happy, you know? Mm-hmm. So,
yeah. So while what is this?
Mentioning about, sorry, Monica, while I was mentioning about valuing friends and colleagues and family, I would like to use this platform to actually sincerely apologize to my colleagues and peers if unintentionally I have hurt them. Because at the end of the day, like I said, we are also stressed and are, you know, we have to keep up with our commitments. Maybe sometimes the expectations are not met, but I might have been hard, and I would like to sincerely apologize them for unintentionally hurting them. But the intent, you know, in this right spirit, please, I hope you understand what I mean out here. So, yeah. So basically what I would like to say here is we should try to divert our attention and focus on things that you love to do or you have never got time to do in the past.
These are some nice pictures that you have of the mandalas that you created recently.
Ah, I forgot to mention this. You know, so the thing is, in one of these these weekends, actually I had taken 2 weeks off the year end leave, and I didn't know how to utilize my time or how, like I said, I wanted to do something different. So I saw in one of the social media platform, one of our hotelier friends posting her creation of mandala art. And that's when I just picked up a pen and a paper and I started, you know, doing some geometrical figures, filling up the spaces. And that's how it turned out to be. I found out, you know, it's a discovery mode, you know, a passion discovery mode, I would say. So this is where I realized that I can also sketch.
These are beautiful.
These are the things which I have never done in the past. And I now would try to utilize my time, my weekends, whenever I get some time.
Yes. So, you know, this is so inspiring. And, you know, I want to throw the question to the audience, you know, is there, in the Weaver session, we did talk about us making that change. And is there anything that you've always wanted to do, but you were unable to do, but you consciously started doing during this time? This is for the audience. This question goes out to the audience. On the chat, you can mention, what's that one thing that you took up because you actually got some time for it? Physical exercise, morning walk. Okay, lovely. So see, I think post Indiver session and now post your session also, Stuti.
Wonderful.
So it's great, you know, and I would like to get everyone to start thinking a little more on these lines and consciously take up some activities, because like Stuti mentioned, it really does a lot for your mental health.
In fact, Monica, I would say one point, if I may. No, I have been living in Mumbai now for almost 25 years. And out of these 25 years, 8 years, I was living in Kandivali. But trust me, I never thought, neither thought nor even got the time to drive down, which is 10 minutes drive from Kandivali to Borivali National Park. So 31st December 2020, I thought I need to do something which would make me happy. And that was the day I actually went cycling inside the Borivali National Park for 2.5-3 hours. Mm-hmm. I mean, there is so much of peace, serenity there. I mean, it's full of greenery. I felt I was in Assam. So guys, whoever have not been to Borivali National Park, I would urge you all, weekend or one of the weekends, please go there and spend your time. It really would boost up your energy level.
Okay. Great. Stuti, just as a final question, I would like to ask you about your mantra to be focused in life. What is your
mantra? Sorry, come again?
What is your mantra to be focused in life?
My mantra. So I would say, self-belief, stay strong, physically as well as mentally. That's most important. Why I would say that I have say what I feel that I, and that too, it's only if you feel from within, that is when you would get. I feel that I have gone through the worst. I have sailed through the worst. I have managed to sail through the worst. Nothing worse can happen to me. Whatever challenges come to me today seem much smaller than what I have gone through in the past. So stay strong, stay focused. Whatever, nothing is permanent. If you're going through bad times, that is also going to sail through. You will sail through for sure. You know, give your best, never give up, and leave the rest to God. You know, tough times do not last. Tough people do. That's my mantra for.
Thank you so much, Stuti. Just having this chat with you and for you to share the kind of things that you've taken up and your journey has itself been very inspiring. And, the last couple of minutes, I would like to keep the chat window open for any kind of questions that the audience might have. Okay, and you will also be able to see a lot of people taking up things like meditation, crochet work. I'm sure these have been very beneficial. So any questions that you would like to ask Stuti, here's your opportunity. We would love to have some more time with you, Stuti, maybe in the future to get a little more understanding on this topic. But yes, it was great. And we all really did get some insights. So thank you so much. Thank you so much for your time.
My pleasure.
Yes. Great. And thanks everyone for joining.
Thank you.
Thank you, Stuti.
Thank you, everyone.
Yes.
Apologies again for the technical error.
Oh, that's Murphy's Law. That's fine. It had to happen. Thank you.
Bye. That really talks about being emotionally well-being.
Control. I mean, you should have really seen what I went through. Chalo, bye. I'll talk to you later.
Yes, bye-bye. Thank you.